बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। दिस इज़ अवर अनदर चैप्टर फॉर द कोर्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल डेवलपमेंट, ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल रिन्यूअल, द चैलेंज ऑफ चेंज। एज द प्रीवियस रिसर्चर्स ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दिस इशू एंड दे टॉक अबाउट ऑन दिस द चेंज एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल रिन्यूअल प्रोसेस। एज मेंशनड ऑन द स्क्रीन, यंग एंड रूबीकैम is discussed about the change and the importance of the change in the management in the 21st century. We know that market, product and competitive conditions are rapidly changing. Under these pressures, organizations are changing. They are downsizing, re-engineering, flattening structures, going global and initiating more sophisticated technology. When we're talking about the change, when we are talking about downsizing, I've been talking about the re-engineering. So in this case, there are some issues related with the morale of the employees, trust factors, productivity had decreased after downsizing. So these are also a concernable issues in the when you're talking about downsizing or when you're talking about re-engineering. Organizational renewal requires the top managers make adaptive changes to the environment. One study suggests that strategic models of top managers play a very crucial role in directing organizational responses to keep pace with changing industry conditions. The focus of organizational development is on changing organizational systems, stressing the situational nature of problems and their system-wide impact. Basically, when you're talking about organizational renewal, the more simple thing is that they are talking about improvements. They are talking about continuous innovation. They are talking about continuous developments in the organization. So for the continuous development of organization, you need to be very much critical. You need to be, your organization need to be very much focused on the development process. Your organization need to focus on the situational nature of problems and others areas of concentration in the organization. Then we're talking about the constant change. Because of the rapid pace of technology, firms are confronted with the early technological obsolescence of products. So in the past, companies could grow during the long lifespan of proprietary inventions. The meaning of the obsolescence is, if we see it, is basically the meaning is this usefulness, basically. Uselessness means that, in other terms, we can say that the technological obsolete, when the technological is not very much useful. So you need to change it. You need to focus on more innovation and you need to focus on more quality oriented element. But today their innovations are often quickly overtaken by competitors with the technological improvements. These problems are the result of the increasing rate of change and are made more difficult because of the impact of future shock on management. So this is also another thing. Then, Further move on to the next slide. Organizational renewal, adapting to change, managing effectively is a major challenge facing organizations today. When an organization fails to change, the cost of the failure may mean its very survival. It means that if organization is not successful, so the survival of the organization is also very difficult. Think small and act small, we will get bigger. Think big, be complacent, be cocky, and we will get smaller. By complacent, we mean that those organizations are those individuals who are very much rigid in the operations. Mostly complacent organizations are mostly complacent peoples are those, or you can say that if you relate it with the structure, so mechanistic structures, all those organizations who follow mechanistic structures, they normally promote complacent attitude. If you see the meaning here, so the meaning of the complacent is self-satisfied. It's not more satisfied, it's more self-satisfied or unworried. These two words are very much, this is also very much, is very much fit here in the situation. Self-righteous. Self-righteous, unworried, self-satisfied people are mostly, you can say that, are the complacent in nature. And when they are complacent, so they are, as the meaning described, that they are not worried about the things, so they not get it, the good things. In the previous chapters, I mentioned two of the examples related with Nokia and Steinway organization. Their employers, their owners are also complacent in nature. That's why the organization is ultimately failed. The OD practitioners then is ultimately interested in changing human behavior and organizational processes to create a more adaptive and flexible organization. So it's already clear to you. Then adapting to organizational renewal may be defined as an ongoing process of building innovation and adaptation into the organization. In the previous slides, I already discussed this, that the organizational renewal means that we defined as ongoing process of building innovation and adaptation. In the physics, entropy is a principle of physics stating that everything that is organized will be breakdown or run down unless it is maintained. Means that this, the same thing is that, as we previously discussed, as stable organization or stable organization as far as operation is concerned is the unsuccessful organization as according to the literature of organizational development. So this is totally related with the literature of change management. This is totally related with the literature of organizational development. Keep in mind in these facts as well. Then approaches to change. Every organization must have enough stability to continue to function satisfactorily and still prevent itself from becoming too static, stagnant, to adopt to changing conditions. Both stability and adaptation are essential to continued survival and growth. A hyper turbulent environment, on the other hand, is characterized by rapidly changing product lines, an increasing and changing set of competitors, continual technological innovation, rapid market growth. Static organization can no longer survive. So same thing is this. As already we discussed it, then the hyper-turbulent environment is mostly related with the telecom sector. In Pakistan, if you see the telecom industry, or if you see the technological industry or IT industry, these are all the kind of the industries which is the hyper-turbulent environment, where the survival of the organization is be only possible if they keep focusing on changing, if they keep focusing on improvement, if they keep focusing on innovation. Then the other important thing is a model of adaptive orientation. A model of adaptive orientation is related with the sluggish management, sluggish thermostat management, stable environment, low adaptation. Sluggish thermostat is a term originated by David Miller to describe organizations that resist change until cost trade-offs favor it. So this is the kind of the state, this is the kind of the management where organizations don't go for the change until and unless they cannot give, or until and unless they not think it, this change if give favor to him, to the organization. So they not move it further for the change. So they are very much rigid in the terms of the change, you can say that. In Pakistan, you can say that a sluggish thermostat management is mostly mostly related with Pakistan, that the WAPDA. You can say that WAPDA is the kind of the management which is the sluggish and low thermostat. So this is, they are low adaptation. So you can say that this is also. So another thing is the PTCL. PTCL is also another kind of the example that they are very resist in the change. When the others companies entered in the market, when the others companies have the innovative ideas, so they follow the others companies as well. Otherwise itself, they are not adopting, or itself, they have a very low adaptation, you can say that. So this is a good metaphor because many organizations set their thermostat so low that they become insensitive to change. So mostly organizations have the kind of the approach or the kind of the mindset where they can low in thermostats. So this also insensitive to the change as well. Moving further, the sluggish management refers to a managerial style based on low risk with formalized procedures, a high degree of structure and control. Organizations that utilize sluggish management have very stable goals and a highly centralized structure. They also tend to have more managerial levels, a higher ratio of superiors to subordinates, value seniority more than performers, averse to accepting new ideas may lead to serious problems in the long run. So this is very true. These are the kind of the mindset. In the low thermostat, people is giving more values to the seniority than the performers. You see a lot of organizations in Pakistan following the same things. So averse to accepting the new ideas means that this is the kind of the organization they not accept the new ideas. May lead to serious problems in the longer run. So this is very true. We are already discussed it. Organizations that utilize sluggish management have very stable goals and highly centralized structure. So this centralized structure means that the complacent and as well as decentralized structure means that organization has a kind of the mechanistic structure. So this is how you can say that the sluggish management is all about. Then satisfying management, stable environment, high adaptation here. Organization is moving to the adaptation process. Satisfying management, a term related to the word satisfactory, that is adequate and average. It is a style of managing that emphasizes a more centralized decision-making structure with problems refers to the top. Planning and decision-making are usually concentrated at the top. Changes accomplished at the rate that is good enough to keep up with the industry. So this is a kind of a good approach that they have a more adaptive in nature. They are more moving towards the change process. They're accepting it. And without change, they would gradually suffer a decline in the performance. So they keep focusing on mostly satisfying management is mostly related with the FMCG's organization. By FMCG's fast moving consumer goods organization is mostly follow the satisfying management. And they have the more they changing their packaging, changing the color scheme, and as well as the taste, and these are all the things. So this is how they, if they do not follow it, so they will suffer a decline in the performance. Then reactive management is also reactive management and sluggish management is relatively the same thing, more or less the same things, you can say that. Reactive management is when the things imposed on them, when the things change, or the others organization change so they can adapt it. Fit the example of the Telenor and the Jazz, you can say that. When Telenor introduces easy load mechanism in Pakistan, or easy load system in Pakistan, so Jazz followed at it. Jazz followed it in the same manner. So this Jazz, at that time, Jazz management is reactive in nature. So this is how you can say that. Then the other thing is renewing, transformational management is the hyper-turbulent, high adaptation here. Organization is going for adaptation, hyper-turbulent. So this is the IT area. IT area is more adaptive in nature. You can say that this is how you can relate it with the in this area. The system approach, finding new ways to work together, the system approach to managing change views. The organization has a unified system composed of interrelated units in an organization engaged in downsizing. Managers may use a system approach to determine how to cut cost. One approach, the horizontal corporation, breaks the company into its key processes and creates team from different departments to run them. It's about managing across rather than up and down. So this is how you can say that these are all the things we are already discussed. Horizontal corporations is the they are more focusing on that the they are more focusing on the top management and the operational management. They are not more focusing on that. They are managing across. They're not moving for the top management, middle management, and the operational management. As these are the horizontal corporations, so in the horizontal corporations, only top management, and the top management is directly dealing with the operational management. Then moving further, the organization as a system. A system is a set of interrelated parts unified by design to achieve some purpose or goal. Every organization can be viewed as a number of interrelated interdependent parts, each of which contributes to total organizational functioning and to the achievement of the overall organizational goals. The notion of system interdependency is critical because in change in one part of an organization system has consequences in other parts of the organization. This is also very simple that when you're talking about the change, so we are ultimately discussing it in terms of that organization is a set of interrelated parts. If you change the IT departments, so ultimately the IT department change has direct influence on other departments as well as. That's true. So they are, because they have interrelated, interdependent parts, so this affects the other departments as well as. So this is also, the interdependency is critical, and because of this, and because of this, you can say that this works. Then, organization as a system, there are two basic, open system and closed system. This open and closed system is discussed already in the previous slides, in the previous lectures. I already discussed with you people open and closed system. So there's no need to discuss again with you. Just to revise, just to give you a brief, open system is, by open, we mean that those organizations who interact with the external environment. And closed system, are closed is basically that is self-contained and isolated from its environment. So this is the open and closed system meaning. Then the socio-technical system, organization development and renewal may be referred to as systems approach to change. An organization is viewed as an open socio-technical system of coordinated human and technical activities. Organizational functions and processes are not considered as isolated elements, but as parts reacting and influencing other systems elements. Socio-technical systems using the following: organize around process, flatten the hierarchy, use teams to manage everything, let customers drive performance, reward team performance. So these are all things. You just read it and you are also listen it. So if you find out any problems in these slides or if you have any ambiguity, so you can ask directly to me from me as well. So we will later discuss or we will later highlight. These are very simple points. So I am just go through with these slides for your understanding as well. Then the socio-technical system, the goals and values subsystem. This includes the basic mission and vision of the organization. Such goals may include profits, growth, survival, and are often taken from the larger environment. The technical subsystem, primary functions, activities, operating, including the techniques and equipments used to produce the output of the system. Then the structural subsystem, then the design, policies, and procedures. Psychosocial subsystem is related with the culture of the organizations. You will talk about in the futures chapters as well as in the later on the in the course we will discuss these things as well. The managerial subsystem spans the entire organization by directing, organizing, and coordinating all activities toward the basic mission. The managerial function is important in integrating the activities of the other subsystem. Lastly, we will discuss the high performance system, high performance models focusing on key five key variables, the business situation, forces in the environment, the business strategy, the goals and values, the design elements, technology structure, etc., the culture, the business results, the outputs, these are all things. Now, this is a very important slide. Here we will discuss number one thing is the business situation. By business situation, we means that in which kind of the organization, sorry, in which kind of the environment you are working. So first to understand the environment, first to understand the environmental forces. This same thing is that you will, there's the